decomposition and mixtures. There are two kinds of chemical processes that can break compounds into simpler components. These are called thermal decomposition and electrolysis. Thermal, as the name suggests, involves heating a compound strongly until it breaks down. For example, when mercury 2 oxide is heated strongly, it breaks down into mercury and oxygen. Coming towards electrolysis, electrolysis is a term made of two words. Electro means electricity, and lysis means breaking down. Therefore, electrolysis is the process in which electricity is used to break down a compound. So, now you understand how to separate the elements of a compound, right? But what happens when we mix two or more compounds? A combination of two or more different substances without any chemical reaction will form a mixture. Each pure substance retains its individual chemical properties. The components of a mixture are not fixed. They can be present in any ratio. The mixture can be classified as either homogeneous or heterogeneous. In homogeneous, the components are distributed throughout and have uniform appearance. It's also called a solution. A classic example of homogeneous mixture is that of sugary syrup. Syrup consists of a mixture of mostly sugar and water. Meanwhile, in heterogeneous mixtures, the original substances are separated into physically distinct regions. For example, the cereal in a bowl of milk for your breakfast. Some characteristics of mixtures are as follows. A mixture can be separated into its original components by using three physical methods, such as magnetic separation, filtration, or distillation. The chemical properties of a mixture are the same as those of its components. No chemical reaction takes place when a mixture is formed. There is usually little or no energy change to form it. Last but not least, the components of a mixture can be mixed in any proportion. The process of decomposing compounds and separating mixtures are very useful in a variety of applications, including the manufacture of cosmetics.